identical lamps. Each having a resistance R are connected to a battery of an EMF psi, right? So psi are shown in this figure, right? There are three bulbs A, B, C has been connected to a voltage of an EMF psi, right? Suddenly a switch S is closed. Here there is one switch is there which has been closed. And they ask us to calculate the current in the circuit when S is open and closed. So they ask us to find current which is when the circuit is open as well as closed. The next, they ask us to find about what happens to the intensity of the bulb A, B, and C. And the third, they ask us to calculate the voltage across the three bulbs when it is open and closed. Then calculate the power delivered to the circuit when S is open and closed. Does the power delivered to the circuit decreases, increases, or remain the same? So these are the three things they are asking in our session, right? So one, they ask us to calculate the current when it is open and closed, and voltage when it is open and closed, power it is open and closed, and intensity when it is open and closed. And they are asking that whether the power is increased or decreased, or it will remain the same. Right? So we will look into the problem, right? So the same thing which has been resistance connected in series and parallel. First we will take current. So we know that Ohm's law formula V is equal to I R. We say that voltage and psi. So E and the psi and V are the same. Therefore we can say that. And they have been given a hint that the three identical bulbs. So three identical bulbs means what? So having a resistance same means R1 is equal to R2 is equal to R3 equal to R. Since the resistance are connected in series, R is equal to R plus R plus R, that is equal to 3R. Therefore, we have found the resistance and we have to calculate current. I is equal to what? V divided by RS. So that is RS value is 3R. Then I value, V value is psi. Therefore, current has been found to be equal to psi divided by 3R when the switch is open, right? When now the switch is closed, what will happen? So the current will flow from here and from here. Only these two bulbs will glow and the C bulb will not glow. Therefore, we can say that. So there are only two resistance has been included in it. Therefore, total resistance will become to be equal to 2R. Therefore, V remain the same. V equal to psi. R will be 2R. When the thing is closed, we can say that I is equal to E psi divided by 2R. Is it clear? So current, when we want to calculate current means when three things are connected in series, it becomes current value will be psi divided by 3R. And it is closed means it will be equal to psi divided by 2R. Is that clear? Right. Now we go for voltage. So voltage when the switch is open, what will happen? We already clearly know that when anything has been connected in series, and current will remain the same and voltage will vary. If it is connected in parallel, we can say that voltage will remain the same and current will vary, right? So therefore, series current remains the same. What is the current? When it is open, the current value is going to be equal to what? Xi divided by 3R. I is equal to xi divided by 3R. We want to calculate voltage for individual because voltage is not the same for a resistance which has been connected in series. Therefore, VA is equal to I into R. I value is I is equal to 3R into R. R gets cancelled. Therefore, the value will become to what? Xi by 3. Since the voltage for these, all the things have the same value. Xi divided by 3, all are R. We can say that all the voltage are same. Therefore, Xi by 3. Right? Right. Then it is closed. When the switch is closed, what is the current formula? I is equal to psi by 2R. Therefore, VA substituting means I into R means psi by 2R into R cancel. Therefore, it becomes to be psi by 2. VB is also psi by 2. In VC, there is no current is flowing. I value is 0. Therefore, the voltage of VC value is what? 0. Is it clear to you? Right. Simply, we have to substitute. So, since current is same, we have to substitute the formula. Resistance remains, I remains the same, R remains the same, and here voltage is also going to remain the same. Right. Next, we'll go for power. So, what is the formula for power? Power is equal to what? V into I. So, for the switch is closed, right, which is open. So, E, the V value is what? Switch is open means V value is psi by 3. And what is the current value? Psi divided by 3R. If I multiply it, it becomes to be psi squared divided by 9R. Therefore, power will remain the same, which is standard in series. Therefore, we can say that when switch is open, power remains the same. VA, VB, PC, it remains everything. PA, PB, PC has a value of what? Psi squared by 9R. When it is closed, if it is closed, what is the current formula? I is equal to psi divided by 2R and V is equal to psi by 2. Therefore, the power will become to be what? Psi squared by 4R. Right? So, 5 seconds. So they are given a graph like this. What is the graph? So it is given 0, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Right? So this is t second. Then next, they are given connected y axis. Right? They are given this is 5, this is 10 ampere. So from this, so that is in 10 ampere remains the same. It comes to 1, right? When it is 1, it is same. Then in 2, it has been drops down. Then after that, it has been parallel till 4. Then straight towards 4. Then it has been again comes to 5. So this is a graph which has been given. They are asking us to find t is equal to 0 second and t is equal to 2 second and t is equal to 5 second. Then what I can find, we know the formula current. They ask us to find what? So determine the total charge that passed through that. So they are asking us to find Q value, right? So they are given current and they are given time. What is the formula which relates us? It's the same thing. What is the formula? We can say that I is equal to Q by V. Since it is dQ by dt, right? So we want to find charge. Therefore, from this equation, we can write dQ is equal to I into dt. I simply we have to multiply. They have given time and we know the current. Right. So when we have to first find, right, what is t equal to 0 second? So when time is equal to 0 second, the current value is what? 10. Therefore it becomes to be, I can say that. So therefore it is I is equal to 10 into 0. Time is 0. Therefore it becomes charge is also what? 0 coulomb. Charge is also what? 0 coulomb. Then next, this is A. Then B. Right, again, dq is equal to I into dt. At 2 seconds, what is the value? At 2 seconds, they have been given a value t equal to. At 2 seconds, nearly that is graph, it can be near 5, right? So at 2 seconds, I is 5. Therefore, it becomes to be 5 into 2. 5 into what? 10. 10 into 2. Right, then, next, dq will be equal to I into dt. At what second? 5 seconds. At 5 seconds, the current becomes to be 0, right? Therefore, I value will be 0. T value is 5. Then it is again, it becomes to be 0 coulomb. It becomes to be what? 0 coulomb. Therefore, we can found that at first t equal to 0, the charge is 0. At t is equal to 2 seconds, the charge is 10 coulomb. And at t is equal to 5 seconds, again the charge is what? 0. Right? So from the graph, we have to clearly note the value of current, right? Is it easy, isn't it? Now we go for the next problem. 8th problem. What is the 8th problem? Yes. Yeah, electronic hobbyist is building a radio, right? He is building a radio which requires 150 ohm. He is want to build a radio that has a 150 ohm, right? And in her circuit, but then she has only 220 ohm, 79 ohm and 92 ohm resistors available. Then how can she connect the available resistor to get a desired value of resistance? What it is? So a person has want to connect a radio circuit. He wants only 150 ohm, but he's having a resistance of, what are the resistance he's having? One is 220 ohm, another one is 79 ohm, another one is 92 ohm. But he knows the value to be equal to what? 150 ohm. Right? So we have to connect it either in series or parallel or both in series and parallel of these two resistances to find the total resistance values to be equal to what? 150 ohm. Right? Is that clear? So we have to connect it. So let us try by different methods. Right? So we'll find that two things has been connected in parallel. Two resistance has been connected in parallel. And the resultant of that resistance has been connected in series. Right? So we have to take all these. So parallel means it will reduce the value, right? So resistance, the total effective resistance of parallel will be less, right? Less than the individual resistance. Therefore, we have to choose this. From these two, three things, we have to choose the parallel condition. So this 92 is nearly equal to 150, right? So we will keep it like this, right? So 220 is very, very high and 79 is somewhat less. So we will connect these two in parallel. So it will be R1 is equal to 224 and R2 is equal to 79 ohm. And we can say that 92 ohm is series, that is R. Right, we will solve this. like that also, right? So R1, R2 is if it comes to what? 220 into 79 divided by 220 plus 79. If I solve this, it will be approximately will be equal to 58. You solve. So either by log the Bagdadian logarithm or by your manual method, you try to solve that, you will get the value of Rp is equal to what? 58. Therefore, these two resistance has been combined into a value of what? 58. Now this diagram has been modified as two resistance, right? So one is series resistance and another one is the series. So this is Rp value. Rp value is equal to what? 58. Rp value is equal to 58 ohm. And this is R3 value. R3 value is equal to 92. Then what is Rs total effective resistance will be equal to what? Rp plus Rp. So what is that? It is 58 plus 92. It's 10, right? So 10 plus this is 10. Again it becomes to be 10, 15. It gives the value of equal to what? 154 that she has been effective. Yeah. So, in order to get 150 ohm out of these three resistance, these 220 and 79, one is a bigger value and lesser value have been connected in parallel and this value has been connected in series. See, however, this value has been reduced to a single value. Parallel connection, the effective resistance will be very, very less. So, if we take that, so we can do that, right? Is it clear? So, this is one of the interesting problems you have to make note of. Right. Then, now we'll go for your main problem.
Try to work it out. Just substitute it and solve it, you can find the answer. Alright?
that is the thing, right? So this is 15 watt. This is 15 watt, and they have been given. This is to be 100 ohm, and this one is equal to 9 volt, and this is equal to 100 ohm, and this one is also equal to 100 ohm. And they have given the direction of current. From here, this dash means I1, right? Then if it goes here it is splitting off, right? So you can say that I3, here it is I2, right? Again, if it is comes here, means again it is I2 only, here it is also I2 only, right? And when it comes here, you can say I4. If we take more than what, more than two or three unknown terms, it, then it becomes to be very difficult. So we have to neglect only, we have to take only two. So here I3 and I2 takes combined means again it becomes to be equal to what I1, right? So that is the diagram which has been given. So now we are going to solve it, right? So we will solve that. First we will name the notation. We say this is A, B, C, D, E, F. Because we are going to apply fifth of first law and second law. We know that what is fifth of first law and second law. So first we are going to take that at B junction. So at B the junction we are going to apply fifth of first law. So which of us states that what simplest junction means the current towards the junctions are taken to be positive and current away from the junctions are taken to be negative. Therefore I can say that I1 minus I3 minus I2 is equal to 0. So from that I can say that what I can say, I can know the value of I3. I3 is equal to, right? I3, if I take I3 means it becomes to be I1 minus. So because we want to find only two variables, so from that we are saying that I3 equal to I1 minus I2, right? Now we will apply Kirchhoff's second law, second rule in two closed circuits. First we will take this circuit, A, B, E, F, A. We know that it is sum of the product of current and resistance in the closed circuit, so it will be equal to sum of the EMF. So we will start writing from this, and if it goes here, it becomes what? So if I start here, so it becomes to be easy, 100 I1. So 100 I1, because that is all, nothing is there. Here it becomes to be what? Plus 100 I3. That is equal to total EMF means what? 15. Only we want two variables instead of I1 and I2. So we can know from this equation, I can substitute what is I3 is? Therefore 100 I1 plus 100 into I1 minus I2 is equal to 15. Then if I multiply, it becomes to be what? 100, 100, 200. It becomes to be 200 I1 minus 100 I2 is equal to what? 15. Then it will be, this is the first equation. Similarly, what we are going to do, we are going to take this equation. I am going to take B, C, D, E, B. Right? Again, we are going to apply the same thing. Right from here, it is 100 I2. When it comes here, right, it becomes to be minus. So I am moving in this direction, current is coming in the opposite direction, means minus. Minus 100 I3. 100 I3, that will be equal to what? 9. That is equal to 9. What is I3 value? I3 value is what? I1 minus I2. Therefore, 100 I2 minus 100 into I1 minus I2 is equal to 9. Right? Then, if I multiply that, it becomes to be what? I can write 100 I1 minus 100 I1 minus 100 I1. This is 100 I1 minus 100 into minus, that becomes to be plus. Then it becomes to be, I can say that it is 200 I2 minus 100 I1, that is equal to 9. So that is your second equation. Now we are going to solve this first equation and second equation algebraically to found out what? I1 and I2. So what is that? We will write it. It becomes to be, by the first equation it becomes to be 100 I2. Right? 100 I2 plus 200 I1 is equal to 50. Right? So what I have to do? Either I have to multiply with the a 2 with this. If I multiply this 2, what it becomes to be? It becomes to be 200, this it becomes to be 400. So 200 into 0.07 minus 100 I2 is equal to 15 to solve this. So you can find the value. I will directly do it. Since it is a simple algebraic equation, you try to solve. We can find the I2 value equal to minus of 0.01 ampere. Right? Then we want to find I3. What is I3? I3 value is I1 minus I2. I1 minus I2 is what? 0.07 minus plus 0.01. Then what is the value? So that value will be equal to 0.08. Therefore, we have found the value of I1, I2, I3. It is simply what? It is a what? Algebraic equations. So we have found what? I1. So I1 will solve. Either you can multiply both. So you can from this also you can find I2. Substitute the I2 value in the equation, you can find I1. So then we have substituted, you will get what? I3. Is it clear to you? So we have been worked out 10 problems, right? So we will do in the next video, we will do about what? Next 5 problems. Thank you.